Assalamu alaikum students, in our previous lecture we studied about the summary of light reaction. That topic which we are going to discuss in our lectures is about the mechanism of photosynthesis, and that mechanism involves light reaction and dark reaction. The summary of light reaction we already discussed in our previous lecture. Today we are going to discuss about the dark reaction. Dark reaction that takes place in the stroma of the chloroplast, and it does not depend on the light. It can take place even in the absence of light. That's why that is called dark reaction, in which food is formed by utilization of ATP and NADPH that are produced during light reaction. This cycle or that reaction discovered by a scientist, by Kelvin. Kelvin was a scientist. He was working in with his colleagues in the University of California, and he was awarded by a Nobel Prize in 1961 for this important discovery. Now, what are the important steps, or what is the summary of dark reaction? In dark reaction, what happens? Carbon dioxide combines with a 5-carbon compound. That 5-carbon compound is called ribulose biphosphate. In the mesophyll, in the chloroplast, that carbon dioxide combined with 5-carbon ribulose biphosphate. When these two, carbon dioxide and 5-carbon compound, they combine together, they form a 6-carbon compound. But this 6-carbon compound formed by the combination of these two, that is not permanent, it is temporary. And that will split into 2 3-carbon compounds. 6-carbon compound will split into 2 3-carbon compounds. That 3-carbon compound, by using ATP and NADPH, these two are produced in the light reaction, which we discussed in the previous lecture. That 3-carbon compound, by utilization of ATP and NADPH, reduced into 3-carbon carbohydrates, and from these 3-carbon carbohydrates, glucose molecules are formed. And these, after formation of glucose molecule, only one molecule of 3-carbon compound will form glucose molecule. The rest of 3-carbon carbohydrate will be used to regenerate what? The original 5-carbon compound. And this process also involves the utilization of ATP. And in this way, after the production of 3-carbon compound, one molecule into glucose, rest of the 3-carbon compounds are used to form again 5-carbon compound, that is original 5-ribulose biphosphate. In this way, 1 carbon dioxide is used to form glucose, and that 5-carbon compound is again regenerated. Now, we can summarize all the steps once again so that it become clear to you what happens. 3-carbon dioxide molecules combine with 3 molecules of ribulose, which is a 5-carbon compound, ribulose biphosphate. Actually, its full name is ribulose biphosphate. 3-carbon dioxide and 3-ribulose biphosphate combine together and form a by their combination form a 6-carbon compound that is not permanent, and it again splits into 2 parts, and the 2 parts are 3-carbon compounds. These 3-carbon compounds will be reduced to 3-carbon carbohydrates by using ATP and NADPH. When reduction takes place, that will need energy from ATP and NADPH. In this way, from this 3-carbon compounds, these 6 are formed, 1 will be used to form glucose. From these 6 molecules, 1 will be used to form glucose, and the rest 5 will be used to form original 5-carbon ribulose by phosphate, and this step involves use of ATP. In this way, ribulose by phosphate will be formed again in the original shape. That is all about the dark reaction. And what is the importance of chlorophyll? What is limiting factor? That we'll discuss in the next lecture.